Hey there, Coding Explorer. Let's look closer at JavaScript statements. Think of them as the sentences in the story you're writing for your browser. Step-by-step instructions for the computer to follow. Each step, that's called a statement. Here's an example. Let's make four statements. First, we declare some variables. Then we assign values to them. We set x to 5 and y to 6. Finally, we add two numbers together. The sum of the x and y variables is stored in z. JavaScript statements can also do things to HTML, like this one. It tells the browser to write the result of the two numbers we just added inside a web page element with an ID of demo. Simple, yet powerful. Now, about all those semicolons. Think of them as punctuation marks. They end each statement, making it easier for the browser to understand where one instruction ends and the next begins. Oh, and spacing. Your computer doesn't care about it, but good spacing makes your code friendlier to read. And trust me, your future self will thank you. Long statements? No problem. If you want to break them into multiple lines, a good place to do that is after operators, like this. It keeps your code clean and readable. Finally, we have code blocks. These are groups of statements wrapped in curly brackets. Kind of like how paragraphs keep related sentences together, code blocks keep related statements together. You'll use these a lot in functions. And that's your crash course on JavaScript statements. Remember, clean code is happy code. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe to get notified about our latest videos. For more coding tips and tricks, keep it locked right here on w3schools.com. Don't forget to try out what you've learned in our interactive editor, Happy Coding.